Good evening. You see, I'm sitting down because I'm old. And I'm playing the trombone, and the trombone beats you up every night. It beats me up, and I come to the stage, and everybody applauds. So he's still standing up there after what the trombone did to him last night. Makes you humble. But we're glad to have my man George here with me. George came here as a baby and played great. And I was in the band playing. I don't know why he didn't fire me. With my band, he could have fired me. So I've gotten so old, I'm too old to die. I've died many times, so you can call me a cat if you want to. But it's great to be here with these guys, with Steve and Steve, his brother, half-brother, Steve. Great to see you all here. It's kind of like being in Birdland. And music in New York was very important. People loved it, and that's what they were doing. That's how they were spending their time and spending their lives on the planet, trying to be a part of or hearing as much good music as possible. I think we have a lady here who's going to talk to you.
Yeah.
Well, before I give it to you, let me tell you, the ladies, if it wasn't for them, there wouldn't be no trombone players up here. No saxophone players. The ladies are the ones. They're the ones that brought us all on the planet.
Mm-hmm. Yes, sir.
That's right.
We have a presentation for you. And here it is. The brass music stand that has a plaque engraved with your name
and the date of this presentation.
Oh, wow. And we thank you very much for allowing us to do this.
This is the most musical I've been. I better take this and go on.
Everybody say Fly Hampton.
Yeah.
Yeah.
We're going to start the evening by playing a composition that I wrote for Dexter Gordon, the album that we did in Scandinavia, titled A Day in Copenhagen.
All right.
We're going to feature George and everybody that wants to play on it. You can come up to it. If he's not playing, he don't want to play no trombone. He played trombone first.
Wow.
But his arms were too short to reach seven positions to play the trombone. Somehow what he had done on the trombone caused him to have a way of playing the trumpet that nobody still understands how it was. They just like it.
Wow. Mm-hmm.
So here we're going to do this a day in Copenhagen. Thank you. Peter Lynn. Kenny Barron on piano.
Yeah.
So good. All these guys are so good. You see, I couldn't play after anybody up here, so I couldn't play on that. They all played too good for me to play after them, so. That's what happened when JJ played with Miles. JJ played Miles will play after me. I'm not playing after him. So he always made sure he played before JJ played. I understand why. It happened to me tonight. We'll play one more for you with this big group, and then George and Kamau will choose songs to play for you. We're going to play one that we kind of dedicate to all the ladies. All the ladies that made it possible for us to be on the earth. If it wasn't for you, we wouldn't be here.
That's right. Yeah.
My mom had a bunch of children. Actually, got so much. Dad wanted to have some violin players, and she said no. You know, maybe trumpet, saxophone, trombone. That's it. I was trombone, but you know, I ain't gonna have no violin players. This tune might have worked good with them anyway. Here is "You Stepped Out of a Dream." Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
Ware and the board of directors of the Wilbur Ware Institute. I'd like to thank you all for coming to celebrate the wonderful 85th birthday of Clyde Hampton. We love you. Thank you all. Clyde Hampton.